Okay, so today our topic is Bernoulli equations, but because I want to explain the Crick's answers last week, right? Because some unit transfers the student may not know why the answer is not correct. So for our quiz, one quiz require you answer the pressure, and we need to have the unit, the PSF. And as I mentioned, the PSF, the dimensional is the bound force per foot squared. Okay. So in that way, so the key question is usually what is the pressures? So maybe you have the mass. The mass is the bound mass, right? And we will multiply the acceleration. So we know the acceleration unit is foot per second squared, right? And then the upper is force and the down is area. So the unit of the area is foot squared. Okay? So but you compare to how different. In here is bound force, right? But in here, the force unit is bound mass multiplied the foot per second squared. So they are different, right? So the key question is, what about the bound force? The unit of the bound force. Okay, so as I said, the bound force is the bound mass. One bound mass multiplied G. Okay, but we know the G, we are familiar with the G is 9.81 meter per second, right? Per second squared. But this is not for our purpose, so we need to convert the meter to foot. So we know 1 ft is equal to 0.30 for 8 meters. So you need to convert the meters to ft, right? So actually I provide you is around these numbers. Okay? So what is the bound force? The bound force is one bound mass multiplied 1g. So actually here is one bound mass multiplied 332.2 ft per second squared. And then you double check the unit here, 32.32. And then the unit here, dimensional, is bound mass ft per second squared. So for your answer, you may compute the number with the unit like this formula, but you need to convert it to the bound force. So actually you need to divide your answer by 32.2 and you convert the pressure unit to the PSF. So you can check it. You can check it. So I forgot the number here for your answer, maybe around the 5.2. I forgot. And this is the pressure unit. But you need to divide it 5002 tata and per divided 32.2 and you will have the PSI unit. So the final answer around 74 PSI. PSF, sorry. Okay, so you can check by yourself. If you write down your answer like this number, the system will just minus 20 score, right? Just minus 20 score. So you still have the score. Okay, so I just described some unit transfer for the quiz last week. So you can check by yourself. Okay, so I remove I just repeat. Okay, so right now we are moved to the Bernoulli equations. Okay, so I write down the Bernoulli equations here. So you exactly know the pressure multiply the pressure plus the gamma z. The gamma z is the pressures induced by the liquid height, and we have the velocity here. This is the pressures induced by the velocity flow, and totally you plus O together and will equal to constant values. So if you don't have this term, if you don't have the velocity term, only have the pressure and the gamma z is derived from hydrostatic conditions. So that means for the Bernoulli equation here is not satisfied only hydrostatic. In here, we discuss with the conditions is kinematic. So we have the additional term in here. But the totally, the summary plus all together is still equal to constant values. So how can we have the Bernoulli equation in here? So again, we need to take care what is our assumptions for Bernoulli equation. So first is steady flow. And the second is we don't have any fixed viscosity force from the top particle. So in here, we is in the steady flow, right? So we don't have the viscous force. Okay, so and the right-hand side showing here is the Euler equation, okay? So the Euler equation tells you if your isometric pressures along the stream lines, the gradient along the stream line is equal to the density multiplied the acceleration along the stream line. So this is the T is the tangent components accelerations. Okay, so we know this equation is follow the Euler equations. So I write down in here. So and the S is the spatial location along the stream line. So the stream line, the piezometric pressures along the stream line, the changes along the stream line is equal to the density multiplied the tangent components of the acceleration. So as we know, what is the tangent component of accelerations? We know include two parts, right? First part is convective acceleration, and the second is local acceleration. So we know velocity multiplied the velocity change with the along the streamline, and plus the velocity change with the time. Okay, so this is the tangent component for our acceleration. But actually, we know this is equal to zero because we assumptions the flow is a steady flow, so the velocity didn't change with the time changes. Okay, so we don't have these items. So and then we can rewrite the equation, become the streamline gradient with the piezometric pressures and the low multiplied V dV dS, right? Because we don't have the state unsteady term, because we consider that the condition is under steady flow. So we don't have these items. Okay? So, and here, I can, we assumptions, there is no viscosity, so also follow the Euler equations. But here I write this part to be, I do the integrations. So if I do the integrations, this part will become a V squared. And here also the ds, but there is divided two, because I do the integrations for these items. If you do the differential of these items with the string s, and then you can go back to here. So in here to here, I do the integrations along the string nine dimensions. Okay, so if you can write in these formulas, and next, I assume the density is always constant values. So I can move the density inside here. Okay, so I assume the density is always constant. That means the flow is incompressible flow. So I rewrite the formula here to become the low V squared divided two, like this. If you can write in this formula, you see there is the dS, and here also the dS. So you can summarize your equations. The left hand side and the right hand side, we have the same items, is differential with the string line. Okay, so inside we have the P plus gamma Z and the plus 2 over rho B squared, and will equal to 0. Okay, if the some item is differential with the string line locations is equal to 0, that means you do the integrations for these items P plus gamma Z plus 2 over log V squared will be equal to constant values. Okay, so if you divided the gamma both sides, so here you will rewrite to become a P divided gamma, and then there is Z, and then there this item will become a 2G over V squared, and still equal to constant values. Okay, so this is the Bernoulli equations, and this is for the pressures. This is follow the pressures form, and we can change to the next one is the headers. We can describe the Bernoulli equation based on the head. So how many head you have? Not right now, you have the pressure head, elevation head, and the velocity head. So if you don't consider the velocity items here, so the equation will go back to the hydrostatic equations. So that means for the previous chapter, we only consider the hydrostatic status. So we don't have the velocity item. But right now we are discussed with the kinematic condition, so we have the velocity term. Okay, so but the idea in here, the Bernoulli equations only satisfy when you consider two points located at the same string line. That means this is the point one, and this here we already have this point one and the point two. If you have another string line like this item shown here, this is the point 3. Okay? But they are different string line. So this formula, only satisfy when two points located at the same string line. So you only can consider the 1 to 2. You cannot consider the balance between the 1 to 3 because the 3 is located at the different string line. Okay, so in here, we know the Bernoulli equation only satisfies if you selected two points and the two points located at the same string line and they are satisfied. They satisfy the Bernoulli equation. Okay, so the physical meanings, because I tell you the Bernoulli equation, there is no viscous force. But I always mention the viscous force is equal to the frictional force. And the frictional will induce some energy loss. Okay? But so in here, we don't have the viscosity, so we assume there is no, this energy is always conservation. No energy disappear, okay, because we don't have a viscous force. But in two cases, it's not always true, right? Because in our environment, some energy will transfer to the heat and disappear, okay? And then the second, we only consider the same string line for any two points. If not the same string line, you cannot use the Bernoulli equations. If the two points not located at the same string line. Okay, and this is very important. The Bernoulli equations, the physical meaning is the balance of the energies. So how many energy we have? We have the pressures, the energy induced by the pressures. And we have the energy in related to elevations. So usually we call that is the potential energy. Potential energies. And we have another energies from the velocity. So we call it is the kinematic energy. So usually why the total energy you plus together always equal to constants. That means the energy always is based on the conservations. Okay, so total energy didn't change. They just transfer to another style. So usually we can transfer the potential energy to kinematic energies anytime, any point. Okay, so this idea is, if you follow the Bernoulli equations, because we know this is an open channel flow, and we have the flow directions. If we put the tube in here, this is a small hole, and we put the static pressure tube here, and we have the high, liquid high. And then we exactly know the pressure at this point. The pressure at this point is equal to gamma delta Z, right? Because we know the height. So in that way, we can make some balance. Because here, we can measure any point along this string line for the pressure. If we know the pressures, we can follow the Bernoulli equation, so we can know the velocity in that conditions. Because the velocity and the pressure you plus together always equal to constants. So this is the idea. If we put the tube, and then we can measure the rising height, and then we exactly know the current pressure conditions. If we know the pressure condition, only one unknown parameter is velocity. So we can know how large it is of the velocity along this channel. Okay, so this is the idea. So we put many tubes And you see, this stage 9 is total head. As I said, the total head is always constant because of the based on the energy conservations. Okay, so you see, we consider the point 1, point 2, and point 3. And the point 2, we have the small closed area, closed section area in here. As I mentioned, if the closed section area along the channel becomes small, the area, closed section area becomes small, and the velocity will increase. The velocity will increase. So you see, when the velocity increase, and this is the energy for the kinematic energies. So we have a large kinematic energy, and the pressure will become small. Okay, the pressure will become small. But then you see, for the point 1, we have the small kinematic energy, but then the pressure will increase. So we always transfer between the pressures and the velocity, pressure and velocity, pressure and velocity. So we decrease the pressure and we will increase the velocity. Okay, so always balance and always plus together equals constants. Okay, so based on this idea, we have one exercise. And the exercise that I tell you, we put the two tube. We put the two, and we look the rising high for a different tube. Okay, the one rising high in the first one point in here is 1 meter, and this is a point 1, and we assume in here the point 2, and we along the flow. This is a string 9 is close. Throw 2 points. So the point 1 and the point 2, they are located. They locate at the same string lines. And we tell you the liquid is incompressible. So the density didn't change when the flow start to when the liquid start to flow. Okay? And then what is the questions? The questions require you answer the velocity in throat station. This is the throat station B2. Okay, and the question tell you the B2, and here is V1. The V2 is 2 times of V1. So here the question tell you the V2 in here is equal to 2 times of V1. So please find the velocity in throw stations. So what is the V2? So the answer, we need to tell and answer the questions for the V2 values. So the idea, because this is 1 and 2 located at the same string 9, so we can follow the Bernoulli equations. So Bernoulli equation tell us P1 plus gamma Z1 and plus 2 over rho V1 squared is equal to P2 plus gamma D2 and plus 2 rho V2 squared. Okay? And then because we already have the rising high for the tube, and the rising high tell us the piezometric pressures at the location 1 and location 2. So this is the piezometric pressures, okay, and I use the PZ1, and here is the PZ2. So we just reorganize the equation. So we exactly know the piezometric PZ1 minus piezometric PZ2. Okay, piezometric pressure difference between the 1 and 2 points And this answer will equal to 2 over rho V2 squared minus V1 squared. Okay? I just reorganized the equations. And for right left hand side, you exactly know, because we have a rising high in here, so this is equal to the gamma liquid and the high, the header, it's a magic 1 minus the header Z, it's a magic header 2. Okay? And the right hand side, we have the rho, 2 over rho, but we keep the V2 squared, but we can change the V1 squared. Because V1 is equal to 2 over V2, right? And we can put here, so V1 is equal to 4 over V2 squared. Okay, because we follow the equation here, the relationship between the V1 and V2. Okay, so you just take a root, and gamma is rho g, so we can cancel out the rho. So here we just transfer these two to the left hand side, and the gamma is rho g. And the H isometric header 1 plus isometric header 2. And the right hand side is 4 over 3 V2 squared. Okay? And we have a row in here, so we divided one row here. And so row can cancel out. Okay, so and finally you can reorganize the equation V2 squared is equal to 4 multiplied 2 in here is 8. So 8 G and what is H? H in here 1 is 1 meter, 2 is 0.5 meters. So 1 minus 0.5, and the 3 in here, so we divided the 3. Okay, we divided the 3. So you can compute the answer for the velocity of the 2.2. Okay, 8 multiplied 9.81 multiplied 0.5 and divided 3 and root, take the root and then you can compute the answers. So 8 multiplied 9.81 and then multiplied 0.5 divided 3 and the root. So the answer is about the 3.6 16. Okay, you can write the 3.62 meter per second. Okay, so the idea is quite clear, because the point 1 to the point 2 along the same straight line, and then we know the flow condition is in compressible flow. And this is a steady flow, okay? And there is no viscous force. So we can apply the Bernoulli equations. And we just try to balance the point 1 and the point 2 for the energy balance. Okay? So I just use one exercise to tell you how powerful of the Bernoulli equation. But for our life, usually we can have some physical phenomena related to Bernoulli equations. Like this is a decaying decadence. For me, I usually drink many wines, and for the red wine is because we know the red wine the price is relatively higher than beers. You know, right? So usually for the good red wine, we need to decating the wine. So the idea is, what is the decating? So you see the movies, usually they drink the red wine and they use the cup, and they usually just shaking the cup. But why the idea, they would like to shaking the cup? Because when they shaking the cup and the flow, we have a circle flow. And the circle flow will have a lot of, you can mix the air with the wine together, and the wine quality will increase and become more, the tasty will improve. Okay, so this is a decanting tool. So the idea, you see the small area in here. Because I always tell you, small close session area, we will have the high velocity in layers. So that in this point, small area, and then we have the higher velocity. And based on Bernoulli equation, higher velocity will result lower pressures. So inside, the pressure inside is small, and the environment pressure is high. So in case the flow, air flow would like to flow inside the heater, so they will speed out the distance between the air and the red wines. So it's a very simple idea, but the decanting tool is pretty high price. Even though they just based on the idea, follow the Bernoulli equation, quite simple, quite clear. But this is very, very expensive. So, but the idea only just they created the small curl station area, and then change the pressures inside, and the air and the environment will trying to flow inside, and mix with the wine. Okay. So it's a very simple idea, just apply the Bernoulli equations. So here the table just summarizes two Bernoulli equation formulas. The one formula, for this one is the header, it's for the head formulas. But the button here is short with the pressure forms. Okay, and there are some recommendations. If your liquid is, your fluid is gas, so please follow the Bernoulli equations with the pressure forms. But you are discussed with the liquids, and you can use the headphones, but they are the same. So just a suggestions, okay? So, and this exercise is another question. Because usually we have a small, if we have the water tank and then we close open, we open the waters, and the water trying to flow out, right? So how many times the water in the tank will totally flow out? So it's a depend on the height. Where is the height for this point, and the deeper height, the flow velocity in here will differ, because we have a different water height, the pressure will differ. If the pressure differs, the velocity will change also. Okay, so the idea is water is in the open tank and would like to flow out, and then the pole on the bottoms. So, and then initially, the elevation is 10 meters for the water. And then find out the velocities at the pole here. Okay, so we don't know the velocity if the height is 10 meters. So in that way, you see the dashed line showing here. This is our string 9. The dashed line showing here is our string 9. So we know the point 1 and point 2, they are located at the same string 9. So again, just follow the Bernoulli equation. You write down the relationship P1 plus gamma Z1 plus 2O low V1 squared is equal to P2 plus gamma Z2 and plus 2 over low V2 squared, right? And then you take a look first for the pressures at location 1. You are familiar with that, right? Because the point 1 is closed on the air, so there is no any gauge pressures at the point 1. And you just summarize, reorganize the equation, so you can rewrite the gamma Z1 minus gamma Z2 will equal to I forgot to mention in P2 years, because of the port, the P2 location at the port, so also locate on the environment. So there is also no gauge pressure at the location P2. Okay, so, and then we only have the velocity term and the elevation term. So I also summarize, there's 2 over rho and the V2 squared minus V1 squared. Okay, so in left hand side, we can cancel out the rho, right? Because here is a rho G Z1 minus V2, and here is still the 2 over rho V2 squared minus V1 squared. So the rho can cancel out, okay? And so the left hand side, we only have the G and the Z1 minus V2 is equal to the 10 meter, okay? But in that exercise, we don't know if actually the V1, and we still don't know what is the V2. And the answers, we need to answer the question for the V2, right? So how about the V1? So if you have a big tank, and there are the water inside, if we cross the port, and the water start drain out, if we observe the water surface in the tank, the surface is decreased. The surface elevation is decreased very small, slowly. So in these questions, we assume the V1 is quite larger, smaller than V2. So it is incomparable between the V1 and V2. So based on these assumptions, so we can write the equation GZ1 minus V2, and right hand side we only have a 2 over V2 squared, because the V1 is smaller than V2. Okay, so finally the V2 is equal to the root 2GZ1 minus V2, and you put the number inside, so 2 multiply 29.81 and the 10 meters. Okay, and you can have the answers. 2 multiply 9.81 multiply 10 meters and the root. So around 14 meter per second. Okay, so that's the Bernoulli, quite simple. If you just check the flow condition is satisfied the Bernoulli equation assumptions. So how many Bernoulli equation assumptions? 3. The first is steady flow. The second is inviscid flow. So no viscous flows. The finally is the incompressible flow. So the density didn't change. Okay, so we just check your questions and satisfy above three conditions, flow condition, and then you can apply the flow condition. And the idea is very simple. And then you need to check the 2 points they locate at the same straight line. If not located at the same straight line, you cannot use the Bernoulli equations. Okay, so the idea is very, very simple and very clear. Okay, so this is also the very famous questions. As you see, the questions, we have the point A and B. So where is the point A? In here. And this is the point B. And the questions require you answer how large pressures on point A and B. So I can tell you if the pressure difference between A and B is large, that means this is very good conditions for the design of the bicycle helmet. Because high pressure difference will result the flow, airflow quickly. If the airflow can move quickly, and then the flow can bring the hot air outside in your helmet. Okay, so the design is quite simple. We assume for the bicycle helmet design, the location A, the pressure should be larger than B, and then the flow will flow start from here to flow out at the location B. So the pressure in here is high, and then the pressure B in here is low. So we try to design a good bicycle head based on the large pressure differentials between A and B. Okay, so in that way, the answer just tell you the air flow, okay, we have the air flow far away from your bicycle head, okay, is the 12 meter per second. And the air density is equal to 1.2 kilogram per meter cubic. Okay, and the question also tell you in location 4, in here, the top of the head, the velocity is 18 meter per second. Okay, so but our questions require you answer what is the pressure in here, P2. The P2 is similar, the same location for the PA. And what is the pressure in P4? So you try to answer the P4, P2 and P4. Okay, so the idea, there's the difference. If you would like to use the Bernoulli equation, you need to satisfy 2 points along the same straight line. So for our first questions, we consider the 1 to 2. We consider the condition, the point 1 to 2. Why? Because the 1 to 2, they are in the same straight line. And another, we consider the point 3 to 4. The reason why, because the 3 to 4, they are located at the same straight line. You cannot consider the 1 to 4 because they don't locate at the same straight line. Okay, so we separate two conditions. This is first one and this is second one. So if we consider the first condition 1 to 2, so we follow the P1 plus gamma Z1 plus 2 over rho V1 squared is equal to P2 plus gamma Z2 and 2 over log V2 squared. Okay, so and first, also this is the pressure 1. The pressure 1, what is the pressure 1? Because the pressure is from the air. So again, we don't have the pressure, right? We don't have the gauge pressure for the location 1. And if you take a look, the elevations between the 1 and 2, they are located the same elevation height. So we don't have the gamma V1 and the gamma V2 because they are the same values for the elevations. So what we still have? We still have the P2, and then we still have the V2 velocities. But as I mentioned in here, the question tell you assume there is a stagnation point. Assume there is a stagnation point. What the meanings? Because the question tell you in this point two, the V2 is equal to zero. The V2 is equal to zero in the point two. The question tell you these conditions. So in that way, we don't have these items. So finally, we know the V2 is totally equal to the 2 over rho V1 squared. Okay, so we put the number inside for this equation. The air is 1. The air is 1.2 densities, and the V1 is 12 squared, and divided 2, and then you have the pressures. Okay, so you use your calculators, and you can compute the answers. The answer is 86.4 Pa. Okay, so we know the P2 is the Pa. The P2 is the Pa. So we answer the first questions, just follow the straight line from the 1 to the 2, and then we know the P2 pressures. Okay, so the second, we consider right now is start from the 3 to the 0.4. Okay, we change the conditions, it's from the 3 to 4. So again, we write down the Bernoulli equation, P3 gamma D 3 plus 2 over rho V3 squared, and then this is a P4 plus gamma Z4 and then plus 2 rho V4 squared. Okay, so again, so in that way, we don't have the P3, right? Because still from the environment airs. And so we make the balance. Our questions, we require to answer how large it is for the P4. Okay, so we just, I keep the P4 and reorganize the equations. So it's gamma D3 minus D4 for these items, and the plus 2 over rho V3 squared minus V4 squared. Okay? So in our questions, what is the D3 to Z4? That's the elevations between the 0.3 to 0.4. So usually we will ignore these elevation changes because we know the bicycle has maybe just a few centimeters high difference. And the gamma is quite smaller if you consider fluid is the air. Okay, you see the density for the air is quite smaller. So only a few centimeter difference high cannot induce a large pressure difference. Okay, so we simply ignore these items because this is the minus. Even though you put maybe the height difference is around 10 centimeters and then you put the answer in here and then you can recalculate the answer. The pressure didn't change a lot, even though you consider the elevation changes with the height higher. Okay, so we only focus on the final term. So the final term, we put a number inside, so 2 over 1.2 densities, and the inside is 3. Where is the velocity 3? The velocity 3 is in here. So the 12 squared minus the 4 is 18 squared. And then you can compute the pressures, how changing it is. Okay, so I use my calculator. 18 squared and 12 squared minus 18 squared divided to multiply the density 1.2 is equal to the minus 108 pa. Okay, so the minus is good. That means their pressure relative to the environment pressure is smaller than environment. Okay, so this is the minus. Okay, so you see there are the pressure difference. Okay, if we have the pressure difference, the air will start to flow. And if the pressure difference is large, and the flow will flow rapidly. Okay, so the idea, if you design a different shape, if you design a different shape of the bicycle helmet, you will have a different velocity condition, right? Because the shape changes, the velocity also changes. And the velocity changes and the pressure also changes. So you need to design the shape of the motorcycle or bicycle helmet, and then you try to have the large pressure difference between the B and A, and then you can have the good, you can have the good detonation conditions. Okay, this is very famous when we design the head. We need to follow this idea. And we just based on the Bernoulli equation, no any other equations. So the idea is very simple. Okay, so sorry, I'm late for the break. So I stop here in the 10 minutes.